This week's Ask Dr. Durie is from an alert myeloma patient who noted a recent publication in the New England Journal of Medicine about a medication called Ide-cel. And so Ide-cel is an abbreviation for a much longer combination of words referring to a treatment which was up until recently called BB2121. And so what is this? This is a type of CAR T-cell therapy. And so this is a type of therapy where a patient's own T-cells are harvested and then engineered over a period of a week or two to target the myeloma cells, in this case targeting an antigen on the surface of the myeloma called B-cell maturation antigen, BCMA. And so this is a type of therapy called BCMA targeted CAR T-cell therapy. And in this recent New England Journal paper published on February 28th, results of 128 patients who had received this Ide-cel therapy were reported. And results were quite promising. 73% of the patients had at least a partial response, and 33% of the patients had a complete remission or better, and 26% of the patients had negative minimal residual disease at the 10 to the minus 5 level. And so really excellent deep responses. And so this was incredibly encouraging, and the side effects were definitely manageable. This type of CAR T-cell therapy does have some special side effects, including something called cytokine release syndrome, CRS. However, only 5% of the patients did have this type of reaction, which can have some effects on the nerve tissue. So this was encouraging. This type of therapy also does cause reduction in the blood counts at a significant degree for the first week or two until the blood counts have a chance to recover. But the very, very good news for patients is that the lengths of the remission were good and the overall survival has been excellent, actually 19.4 months. And so for patients who achieved the deep, deep responses, the average length of the remission was actually 19 months. And so patients receiving this therapy have been just so pleased that they are in remission for 1 year, 2 years, some even a little longer, and they're off therapy. The normal procedure for a myeloma patient is to go in once a month and have ongoing therapy. And so the first time for many years, many patients are experiencing a treatment-free remission period, which is truly wonderful. So there is a lot of enthusiasm about this therapy. There's a lot of interest in what can we expect if this therapy could be introduced earlier in the disease course. And so a new trial, KARMA-4, is getting started in patients with high-risk myeloma, where the therapy will, in fact, be introduced much earlier. And so bottom line, this is really an exciting and promising game-changing therapy, actually. And so we're looking forward to the results of the ongoing FDA review. It is expected that we will have some feedback from the FDA by the end of March, and so the results are promising, and so we're hoping that this will allow broad availability of this type of new therapy.